John, who spends part of his life in the 18th century, as I do, who also loves its heritage of pictures and books, with kindest personal regards and all the best wishes from Paul Mellon. 1962. I'd only been working for him for a year then. It was a remarkable relationship, and I think in a sense he found somebody who shared his deep interest in British life, really. He arrived in England and I was told to go to Claridge's at 12:30 to be interviewed. At 12:30 exactly, I knocked on the door and Paul Mellon came out holding a martini glass, you know, filled with martini, and said, it's a bit early, but I wondered if you'd like this. And I thought, oh, this is the right sort of chap. He was so pleasant and genial. It was a most unprofessional interview. He was nervous, said, do you know America? And I said, no. And he said, you don't know Virginia? And I said, no. I said, I've read Gone with the Wind. Oh, that's great, he said. It hasn't changed that much. The first job he gave me, effectively, was to try and persuade Basil Taylor to take a salary, because he had refused to do so. And I had to come back and said, my first job, I've completely failed. And he said, well, no, don't worry, I thought you would. So rather cunningly, he established the Paul Mellon Foundation for British Art. And obviously he knew that the idea would appeal to Basil. British art was not very highly thought of, that was an understatement. People were very dismissive of British art at that time. And Basil Taylor inspired Paul Mellon, in a sense, to change that. In the autumn of 1961, I engaged John Baskett on Basil Taylor's recommendation as my first curator. John had spent a number of years as a student in the Department of Prints and Drawings at the British Museum and in European print rooms, and had also acted as assistant to his father in the London firm of Koulnagis. So he had experience in both the museum world and the art trade, and was able to take 2 years leave of absence from his firm to come and help me. Up to that time, Bunnie and I had been in the habit of going about the house with a bag of nails and hanging pictures where we chose. Well, as far as hanging the pictures, banging the nails into the wall, he still did it. But there was always that wish on his part to collect British pictures, because he liked British life. His mother was British, and came from Hartford, where there's a daughter of a brewer there. In fact, Paul and I went up and tried their ales. It was very good too. This is by William Shakespeare. There is a tide in the affairs of men, which, taken at the flood, leads on to fortune. Omitted, all the voyage of their life is bound in shallows and in miseries. On such a full sea, we are now afloat. We must take the current when it serves, or lose our ventures. I think it happens to most people at some point in their lives, don't you?